before he gets Black Cleaver, because a Rek'Sai who has a tunnel in to do damage with 1200 HP is not useful in a 5v5. And like, if he ganks, it's stupid good. But
Will
if he
people actually
5v5,
go warrior and like competitive? I feel like he's just so squishy.
that's what I mean. I played it. I went warrior last time I scrimmed.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, that's why we couldn't do
But
Baron.
I mean, I was it.
You're
But
all
like the.
dying of Baron, bro.
Yeah, I know. That's why I was like, I can't take Baron,
All
bro.
yeah, all 3 years, dude. You couldn't take
No, but the
Baron.
thing is, that's not like a good representation of how good the build is, because I was like 5-0 every game. So like, you can't really tell, you know what I mean? Like, what if I'm 0-0-0? Like, as long as we don't die to this Rek'Sai 5 times.
Yeah.
I don't think they'll invade.
You need to be careful of Rek'Sai level 3-ing bot. Like,
Okay.
he's gonna start
Like
Raptors,
what,
because
240?
yeah,
240,
240.
right?
Usual ward 225.
Okay.
Because he's gonna have to do Krugs unless he's taking experience runes. I'm mad.
Can't you get XP runes and do that
Yeah,
batting?
exactly. But I don't think Iconic is the type of player to do that.
That's some
Let me check it
cheesy
again.
happy, that's all it is. Well, it's like, it's not like all your fault drastic, because like that's just, you're the only engage in our team, so it just like sticks out, you know?
Yeah.
But yeah. When like our only form of engage is Ash Air or Varusar, I just gotta like be really careful with using
it. I just gotta hold it, yeah. It has to be like a sure.
No, even though I died so much, I felt so much.
Well, like early fights are really weird with Malzahar, because like, I don't know, like when people don't have QSSs and they're really squishy, someone's just gonna get fucked if they play it right. So.
Fuck that matchup.
Dude, the dive bot, I was up 30 CS before they dove 3 man. Bro, that's worth though, if we caught him.
Actually, that actually won us the game.
I mean,
him not having flash.
Won us the game, because he burned his flash earlier, so then, I mean, you can't really expect. He's playing to expect that the other AD carry sucks, which worked this game, but like I don't even understand how he even got hit by like R in the last fight.
Dude, that fucking max range, dude. He flashed and I still
just
got
just the tip,
him.
Dude. Dude, I was gonna say you should just go cooldown boost if you're gonna do this, so you have more flashes, but Jin went cooldown boost. So it'd be the same thing anyway.
Dude, they fucked up like mid game when they were playing Malzahar, right? They kept flash ulting me when I had QSS. And then they never went for like Fiora or our AD carry who didn't have QSS until
I was
like...
expecting so much for that Malzahar.
Yeah, I know. Go. Like if Malz is, if you were just laning against Renekton and then Malz just like walks your lane.
That's what he should have done. I was just warding, just sitting back.
They didn't do anything. They just kept ulting me. Like I was really confused. Oh, that dragon fight, that was my fault. That wasn't
Fiora's
fault.
I don't know, though, because, like, I think Fiora is actually more useful than Renekton in team fights. So we can.
Well, that's only for our team comp, because we had Cass. So Cass just shits on Renekton. But if, like, you're, like, another mid laner, like, I don't know, not Cassiopeia, Renekton could just blow you up with Rek'Sai.
We should have played
so much time bot.
Like, we should have tried a force bot tower, because I was up like 30 CS, dude.
Well, I think the one time we were going to is just a reactionary play.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, we should have done like a.
It was after Visty got killed or dived top lane.
Yeah, was it, were you guys communicating that? Because I'm not, I don't remember hearing
Ash wasn't
that.
Saying anything, or like not much, so it was really hard. Because all of Drastic's comms are, can we fight? Go, I'm ulting. That's all Drastic ever says. I can't believe the fucking Jin never bought QSS though. That didn't make any sense. play against Rek'Sai, as long as you get the game past 30 minutes, the champ is actually just not a champ. So, as long as you stall, like, we just win. Like, that game, we just have better solo lanes, I think.
Doesn't give him like any other stats worth having.
Yeah.
The AP gives true damage.
I'll be right back.
Support, that's pretty useful. And then fucking mana regen too. Which also. What is the lockage?
I can't believe he hit all four shots.
Yeah, I was like, oh, I don't need to block this. He's just gonna take the first shot and we'll just back off. Oh, he's dead. I like didn't even process that he could die of that. I think they actually buffed Jhin last patch.
I was actually winning really hard until I died. I died in my jungle, and then he got the kill, and then he got a level off that, and then Cass got two kills. So then Cass was really far ahead, and then I was really far behind. And then the dragon play where he got four kills. So then I just got really far behind.
Yeah, that mid tower died, like, died so late. It should have died so much earlier.
Yeah.
What time was that play when Blabber is calling to go on the 2 under tower?
Which 2?
It was Shannon, I think, when they were doing Dragon. That's what you can do with mid priority. I just wanted to use it as an example.
Wait, Shannon, Rek'Sai? What do you mean?
Like, they split their resources to do Dragon and hold mid. We could just fucking kill them. Because, like, it's
Two
people, and then we take mid.
I said to flash ult with Varus, but.
You said it with, like, kind of a.
Yeah, I wasn't, like.
Questioning tone,
yeah,
so
I, like,
I don't
like,
think
flash
he went
with
for
Varus,
it.
And then. We just didn't. I guess I just got to be more blunt, like, we should do this. Because, like, that was pretty free, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Especially because Shen was there, so, like, he couldn't even ult. You know what I mean?
Yeah, exactly.
Like, we would be engaging
right
on
back.
Shen.
Yeah, they couldn't kill me anymore.
I don't know.
smashed into a connected and then died.
It's,
and then
okay,
I looked
so
at the game later on and he was just going off. I'm like, wait, what?
The thing is, like, the reason they were losing ball lane was because Shady's awful. Like, I don't think Xpecial is good, right? But I think he's much better than Shady. So now, and like, Ryu's always been not terrible. Zig is not terrible. So, like, if as long as, like, Arrow and them do well, he now has three lanes that aren't getting, like, that just aren't getting shit on. You know what I mean? Like, before, when Inori was playing, bot lane was just getting shit on every game. That's why he had to put so much focus on bot lane. Like, when the casters were like, Mike puts more focus in the top and mid, that's because he can now, like, or else before when Inori was playing, their bot lane was just getting shit on because Shady doesn't know what he's doing. But range carries aren't a thing anymore. They're not. It's not that good. And like, I'm pretty sure I could play Karma in win lane. Okay. Yeah, I don't think he's that. I mean, actually, I don't think he's very good. But I think out of all the supports in LCS, he's the worst. But I don't think he's, like, worse than any of the solo queue supports. I don't think he's that bad. I just think he's, I just don't think anything's worse than him. Maybe Matt. It's one or the other.
Did I want to play Ash, dude?
Yo, what about Jhin?
Ash is Yoden's in Jhin.
If they ban three junglers, I just don't want to play, by the way.
You're gonna ban Rek'Sai. I doubt they give him Rek'Sai. Ban Thresh, dude. Take Rek'Sai, dude.
Dude, I play Thresh. Let's crank. Zion?
It's not really engaged, is it?
Zion is engaged.
Blitz is like playing
around.
Okay, I'll play Bard. No, dude, Braum is boring.
Dude, that Galio can be supported.
Oh shit, they got Galio? Alright, let's hope he goes top lane.
Oh my god. No, it's mid Galio.
Anti fun. It's like Kassadin. Just cast my abilities and they don't do damage.
It's one trick Graves. Can you?
Oh, yeah. Speaking of Kassadin, he's pretty good into Taliyah, I think.
Can we just go Karma Ash?
It could be Galio support too, by the way. Yeah.
Dude, wouldn't Rek'Sai be so good with Galio support?
Shen support just sounds awful.
You can basically just jump in as Rek'Sai and have the Galio back up.
Dude, I used to play Shen support when it was cool.
see TSM's comp with Rakan, Galio, and Jarvan? Oh my god. That comp was sick.
Wait, they're gonna play Tahm Kench.
Why?
Because we have Ashe. Okay.
You ban Tahm Kench, dude, or I can't kill anyone. If they don't have Tahm Kench, I'll fucking snipe all of them.
Dude, Jhin damage
oh,
is
God.
Crazy.
If they get
dude, how come you don't play Jhin Jurassic?
Did I actually play him? I played him a lot before they nerfed him. I just don't play him in solo queue because it sucks. Yeah, I can play Jhin, dude. My Jhin.
Does he play Kled?
Like a tiny bit. Kill myself.
Misty, are you on a team?
No, not right now.
I thought you were going to a LAN team.
I was. No, I was gonna go to OPL, and then I didn't want to.
Wait, what's OPL? Oceanic?
Don't close in OPL.
Tainted mine.
The don't close in OPL, dude.
Wait, Dakola, right?
Yeah, Dakola.
What about the players?
Renekton has got Rek'Sai.
No, they're playing Blitzcrank.
How much does Sin play? Okay.
They wanted to give me like 7.5 grand for homing.
Case, how much do you think they paid Dakla? You know how much they pay their players?
No, it's the Galio
no,
mid again.
Nautilus Blitz Galio.
What the fuck?
No.
Oh, it's Rumble. Wait, it's still Galio mid though. Actually, we can kill Galio with Talia Rek'Sai. We just want to get Renekton ahead, honestly. Get shit on him. Probably dive him.
They might level 1, try invade. We can stack. Okay. Oh, can I start? They have Blitzcrank.
They just put it all into the Blitzcrank hook.
They have the Killis comp.
Basically, like, they have team fight, but they don't have a good way to start a fight.
They have Blitzcrank hook.
Hesitation is death.
Understood.
When did I take you? You know, that was my first game not on Rek'Sai release, and like.
I'm angry.
I only played Rek'Sai. I only played Rek'Sai at least for like the past 4 days because I was like actually trying to get rank 1. And then yesterday I was at 1,115 LP, right?
And then you lost.
No, and then 15 minutes in, we were winning, right? We were winning every single fight, and then my internet goes out, and then I lose, and then today. I'm going like 10-0 every game, and I still top lane!
Wait, they picked, they picked Rumble. I thought they picked Nautilus. Yeah, I guess their last pick, huh?
Should I go B-Vale or Landry second? Probably Landry's, huh?
You're funny, Blabber.
How am I funny?
Your reaction to shit is hilarious.
I just can't win!
Oh no, I was gonna go Ghost. Actually, maybe, yeah, Ghost probably.
Oh my god, dude. What about Cleanse?
I was thinking Cleanse, but they only have Galio CC.
They're gonna look to kill mid, like level 3.
We should stack. They're
this
gonna
is, this
invade.
Is a solo queue.
No, they're gonna invade.
I'll be right back.
Oh my goodness.
Is Mechlo back? I think for our dragons or barons, like when we're doing objectives, just listen to my call. If you don't agree with it, listen to it anyways and just tell me after, like, afterwards, after the game, like, what do you think we could have done better? Because, like, there's no point in me making a call and then someone else making another call and then half of us are doing one shit and half of us are doing the other shit. And then, like, if you don't like it, just tell me, like, after the game, that why, or, like, after that play, maybe. And then if, well, Mankov's not here, but I was going to tell him, like, so what he should be doing is he should be telling us when we need to push out mid-wave. Okay? So if we need to shove out waves, that's Mankov should be telling us that. And then Tran should be telling us, like, where we need vision. Okay? And how we should set up vision for the objective. But we're actually doing the objective. If I say finish, just finish. And if I say turn, just turn. Okay, don't be like, half of us be like, no, finish when it's not like 2k, and half of us be like, turn. So then three of us leave the pit, and then two of us are doing it at like 3k HP.
Yeah, I agree. I think just listen to what
yeah,
was
yeah.
assigned to that. Yeah.
Wait, are we stacking here or here?
Can we ward that and
up
stack
here.
Here? Yeah, can we
Rubble.
I'm gonna auto him. I'm faster.
Yeah,
let's go. Fucking go.
Why did that work?
Wait, shut up.
I thought he would hear.
What am I watching?
Wait, shut up.
Dude, we
wait.
Fucked him up.
Oh shit.
I thought he would heal. He was so low. He
wait, stop. What's up? Green flash?
They
flash.
All flash.
I think they actually all flash.
Yeah,
yeah.
They all flash.
Rumble flash.
Yeah.
Had to.
Okay. I know Blitz can use both songs. Okay.
Blitz almost died and he stuck around for another hook. Holy shit. He used both his potions. Wait, what? No?
Flash was GA. I just kill him.
Kill her.
Shit.
Kill her. Yes. Yeah. I think, like, what we were supposed to do was, like, ult them off, right? But Kate got caught. Like,
tower.
Kate's not supposed to
get
caught behind the wall, you know what I mean? So then we hit arrow, so then you need to change it if we hit the...
Well, we should. We could have done it on an inhib tower. We could have done it on an inhib tower. Yeah.
We knew Graves could be there. We just had to wait a couple of seconds because we were shoving. And then I hawk shot at Tom, so he wasn't there, so he's gone.
Yeah, I think the idea was fine. I just should have called for it on the sideline because then we can get the inhib tower,
yeah. Yeah. I think it was a good call.
The only real weird pick was the Blitz. If they can win like 2v2's top, then Rumble could be a problem in grouping. Because Rumble can win that matchup, I'm pretty sure.
But we isn't like Karma Stick.
The Blitz laning is actually so good. Like, he was able to zone us every time Graves was bot side. Because if we get hooked, you're dead.
Yeah. I also think, we shouldn't have done that swap. Because me and Missy were gonna take the tower anyways. Because, like, did you see the way he was playing? Like,
if we're doing that swap, I don't think you guys should engage on him, like, that fast. Because if we were there and you guys engaged on him, if he flash, if
I
me
arrow.
And Ash are there, he can arrow right after the flash happened. So
no,
it's
but we
like
didn't.
Free.
We didn't lose the trade because like we didn't kill him. Like we burned his flash earlier. Then he started playing safe. We lost it because
he
just ulted the way.
No, but
like
we could have killed him. We could have killed him if we're there.
Wait, but if he had flash, you just flash the arrow, and then same thing
would
happen.
You guys go first, and then when he flash, Ash would arrow. He wouldn't gotten his ult off. He would die there. I think
so. If we go on him, he flashes. He has time. Like after he flashes, he can just ult. It's not like the arrow's gonna hit him immediately, dude. It's not like I can just hit him, and then he flashes. Like the arrow's just like insta on him.
Yeah, but if he ults you guys instead of the wave, we would get the tower, because he would die, for sure, 100%, and his ult is not touching the wave, so we would get kill and tower.
No, but like earlier when he got his flash, he didn't ult us either.
So we're playing one more, dude?
You lied.
No fucking way, I don't want to.
You lied.
Please. Can you just tell him we don't want to?
I see what you're saying, but what I'm saying is, like, had you not made that play earlier, you waited, like, 20 seconds for us to run up, I think we would have been able to get both.
Tell him our top laner
okay.
has to go.
Yeah,
I gotta go.
I guess it's just, like, a window of opportunity,
like, Mystic
but
can
at
only
the same
play,
time, we didn't, like, we didn't prep for the play, enough in advance, I think.
Yeah,
because we were recalling. We're like, okay, we should switch top. We should have talked about that like while we were pushing the wave.
Yeah, we should have told you before.
Mista got a smurf now.
Thanks, Misty.
Are we done?
No problem.
I really appreciate you playing with us.
So when is he coming back?
I thought he booked it already back. Isn't it tomorrow?
I gave it you all.
Misty, can you play tomorrow?
Yeah, probably.
Okay, we're good to go.
Hey.
Alright, see ya. Thanks, Misty.
As long as Blobber promises not to AFK in any more of my games.
Oh my god, that was an accident. My internet went out, dude. That put me on my tilt streak. I was three games from rank one. I was three games from rank one.
If you won that, I think.
Oh, dude, if I won that, I wouldn't have been tilted. If I won that, I would have played more last night and I would have been winning.
Dude, I was watching that game.
That was
I was
so
watching
good.
It from lower low.
I was like 12 and like 2.
I saw, he was, dude, Lorelo was like, dude, he was so pissed. Cause you guys were gonna win, I was watching it, and then.
You know, just tell him I don't wanna play. If they really keep begging.
Did they added this, did this guy got added to CLG sub roster? This Diamond 3 player. I'm looking at the contract database.
What's his name?
One Diag, he's Diamond 2.
He plays on, or he used to play on you, Mitch.
Dude, who are these people they're adding, dude?
Okay, first of all, his name is not One Diag. His name is One Dig.
His name is
Diag.
But who is this? Like, why are you linking him?
No,
oh,
just,
dude, I'm pretty sure he decayed to D2.
Just got added.
No, he didn't.
The sub. Dude, he was Diamond 2 last season, Diamond 2 the season before that.
Who?
Why aren't they just adding Blarfish too?
They just
added
this guy.
Who at CLG?
Yeah.
CLG?
Yeah.
Wait, what's on CLG? Wait, who's on CLG?
This guy, they just added him as a sub. I don't know who he is.
CLG Black?
No, CLG the actual main roster. Like, as a sub, like Joey.
Yo, I love Joey. The air is dry.
Interesting, dude.
Yeah, so new highlight videos out here. Check this out.
He's Diamond 2. And he's on the CLG main roster sub.
Yeah, is he even a support man? I don't even know what he plays, dude.
It looks like he plays AD carry.
Do you guys play Battlegrounds at all?
No.
Oh.
Oh, no. I wish I did.
This guy literally goes to like hundreds of streamers and just gets all the best clips, and it's just the greatest thing ever.
Would he snipe streamers?
No, he goes and watches their streams and makes clips of all the like great. Like, you don't have to play the game to find some of this shit funny. Like the car physics and the ragdolling is just actually the funniest shit ever.
Dude, so many people play this game, I should buy it. Is it actually fun?
Depends how good your computer is. Like, my computer actually just can't run it.
Oh, I can run it. I have a good computer.
Dude, who's this guy with the funny hair and mustache?
Dr. Disrespect, dude, you don't know who that is? You should actually watch his stream. He's so fucking funny.
Wait, they're just, like, gunning down cars.
Yeah.
What is going on?
Dude, I'm pretty sure if we had Cedar Hills 2 games, I know.
Misty is very...
so easy. Yeah.
What?
Yeah,
I don't know. Misty is so bad. No offense.
He is.
No flame, but like...
See, look, Blabber's more toxic than me.
Dude, he's playing with one hand, though.
Yeah, but you tell to their faces.
I'll be gold if I had one.
What? Dude, I eat a
in the middle of the game, Chen just like, you
face.
Fucking degenerate.
He
he's
is.
Like, what
the
fuck are
like,
you doing,
retarded.
You degenerate?
He's like,
you're
retarded.
Playing League of Legends. How are you even in my game? You're so bad.
So we had a Katarina main in our team, and then Francis was like, you're retarded. He's like, can't you see? He's passing through the wars. You're retarded.
Dude, I just can't help myself sometimes, you know? I'm usually pretty good about it, but sometimes I just gotta take him out.
Don't sound bad, because I like to camp, like, I like to play topside. Or at least on Sky, I like to play topside.
Yeah, we're good so, bottom. We can play safe. Or we can,
I mean, it's a fine play style, I think.
Yeah, I don't think it's
he
terrible.
Plays Sky Chance and he fucking goes off, dude.
Holy shit, some of these, like, I'm watching that video, Cloud, and they're just, like, he's just, they're just gunning people,
man.
Hella people down.
So, what are we gonna do Wednesday, by the way? Okay, ask them to move to 12, because I'm going out at 7, around. Or for you, it's like 4.
Alright. Let me know when the...
Alright.
Wait, also, last thing. For the tournament realm accounts, when are we playing them again? The 'Cause if we get them earlier, I'd rather play earlier. 'Cause I don't want to leave early on my internship or like at work. 'Cause it's like the first week, and I don't want to like leave
early.
They're
like,
you know?
Beating people down with the fucking frying pan.
But PS, that shit
it's
is
just normal working time.
Incredibly
it's like
rare.
9 to 5.
Holy shit!
It's almost
like
impossible to kill someone with a frying pan.
Yeah, pretty much. I'll obviously free then, yeah. I just think you scrimmed it at 2 to 5, so I wouldn't be there for, like, first.
Melee weapons in this game are so garbage.
No, I can do 2 to 5. I just have to tell them, like, I have to leave early, but I don't, like, I don't really want to leave early first week. It looks kind of bad. It's like, I already just got to work, and then, like, I'm like, I can't come. Like,
Alright.
Alright. Yeah. Thanks.
Alright, yeah, later. See you guys.
responsible under law for the health and safety of everyone in that house. Over the past few weeks, I spent a lot of time researching laws and regulations within the regions of Australia, combing through evidence and uncovering some new information, and I want to share with you what I found. Before I get too far ahead of myself, though, I need to state some things. I'm not a practicing lawyer in Australia. I just want to share with you my opinions on the topic, and my opinions based on the laws we're going to talk about and discuss in this video, involving the player testimony as well, and the interviews that they've done, and the information they posted online, the screenshots, all of this put together. And we're just going to talk some hypotheticals about how this all relates to the Tainted Mind situation. Okay, so we're going to have to make three assumptions on this case for the foundation that we build everything on. First assumption, we're assuming the players, the coach, and the manager's testimonies are true when it comes to the living conditions in the gaming house and their interactions with the Tainted Mind's upper management. I've talked with parties involved. I've read all the testimonies, articles, and interviews posted online. I've seen, read, watched, talked with as many sources as I could find. And I believe that these testimonies are true. There are plenty of screenshots, photos, and videos that support their testimonies. The second assumption, we're assuming that the gaming house was a workplace and that the players, coach, and manager were considered workers. This one is obvious to me, but a lot of the law hinges on this fact being acknowledged by the Australian government, which I believe would agree that this was indeed a workplace. In the letters of engagement sent to the players, it stated that they were required to live and practice in the gaming house. While the contracts that they eventually signed did not have language that specifically stated word for word what was in the letter of engagement, I do think the letter of engagement showed Tainted Mind's intent. Under Australian law, a workplace is a place where work is carried out for a business and includes any place where a worker goes or is likely to be at while at work. The Work Health and Safety Act of 2011 for New South Wales defines a worker as the following. A person is a worker if the person carries out work in any capacity for a person conducting a business or undertaking. This would include independent contractors as protected in this act as long as they were expected to be at the workplace, aka the gaming house. Third assumption, we're assuming that because the gaming house itself is located in New South Wales, it's those work safety regulations that Tainted Minds would have to follow. Businesses in Australia generally have to obey the laws and regulations in regions they operate within. One of the most important laws to my argument is the Work Health and Safety Act of 2011, number 10, of New South Wales government in Australia. The main object of this act is to provide a balanced and nationally consistent framework to ensure the health and safety of workers and workplaces by, and I quote, protecting workers and other persons against harms to their health, safety, and welfare through elimination or minimization of risk from work or from specified types of substance or plant, and providing for fair and effective workplace representation, consultation, cooperation, and issue resolution in relation to work health and safety. I need to state that Tainted Mind is a business to the equivalent of an LLC.